Some days we just don't have 90 minutes to take ourselves through a full Ashtanga practice. So in today's video, I'm going to guide you through a 30-minute Ashtanga practice that's going to leave you feeling strong and flexible. So grab your yoga mat and let's get started. Let's start at the top of the mat in mountain pose, Tadasana. Lengthen up through your spine, relax your shoulders, dangle your arms to your sides. Take your gaze straight down in front of you and allow your eyes to be still. Our gaze is drishti. And let's move into our Ujjayi Pranayama, victorious breath. So breathing deep into the lungs, slight constriction in the back of the throat. Just like you're fogging up a mirror. Breathing in and out of the nose. Jaws relaxed, unclench your teeth. You should be able to hear a very soothing sound to your breath. And as you're focusing on the breath, engage your energy locks or bandhas. Starting at the base of the spine, pull up. Pull the low belly in. Relax through the shoulders, arms, and hands. Bring your hands to your heart center. Samasthitihi, equal standing pose, is where we'll end up after these series of postures. So let's inhale, float the arms up, look up, and exhale, fold all the way down. Chest to thighs, drop your head. You're gazing towards your nose or your knees. Inhale, lift halfway, flat back. Exhale, plant your hands, step back. Knees up or down, shoulders in front of your wrists, bend your elbows. Lower halfway or all the way, low push-up, chaturanga. Scoop the heart up, tuck the tailbone, and look up. Elbows can be bent for cobra, higher for up dog. Tuck your toes, down dog. Push into your hands, let your chest sink. Lift your hips a little higher, and then kind of tuck your tailbone down. Keep those bandhas engaged, our energy locks, right? Seal the good energy in and release and untie knots of negative energy, often rooted by fear or doubt. Up on the toes, bend your knees. Exhale, step or jump to your hands. Inhale, lift halfway, and exhale, fold. Stand up, stretch your arms above your head, look up, and exhale. Samasthitihi, hands to heart center, gaze to your hands. Inhale, arms up, look up. Exhale, hinge forward. Gaze to your nose or your knees. Inhale, lengthen. Gaze straight down or third eye. Exhale, plant your hands. Step or jump, high to low. Pull forward and lift your back bend. Up dog. Down dog, tuck your toes. Lift your hips. Let's breathe. Good. So we move at a brisk pace to elevate the heart rate, to generate some heat in the body, preparing for these postures that we'll be holding for a few breaths. So we build strength and increase flexibility. Good. Inhale up on the toes, bend the knees. Exhale, step or jump forward. Inhale, halfway, and exhale, fold. Stand up, stretch your arms above your head, look up. Hands to heart center, Samasthitihi. Let's do one more sun salutation A. Arms up, gaze up. Exhale, forward fold, drop the head. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, hands down, send it back, high to low. Upward facing, downward facing. Good. So this physical movement, right, starts to build that strength and flexibility in the body. The breath and awareness of the bandhas gives us that clear, calm, and focused mind. Truly a match made in heaven. Bring the chin towards the chest to engage your chin lock. This is optional. Taking your gaze towards your navel. Inhale up on the toes, bend your knees. Exhale, step or jump forward. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, fold. Stand up, stretch your arms above your head. Look up. Exhale, hands to heart center, moving right into B. Utkatasana chair pose. Bend the knees, float the arms up, and look up towards the sky. Exhale, straighten your legs. Forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, halfway lift, and exhale. Let's send it back again, guiding our way through to downward facing. Now, without hesitation, step your right foot forward, back heel flat. Warrior one, arms rise, look up. Exhale, release, step it back. Again, moving through to downward facing. Left foot forward, back foot flat. Inhale, arms rise, look up. And exhale, release. Good. Woo, I feel that heat rising. All right, hold here and down dog. Now notice, with the body getting warmer, you might be able to sink just a little bit deeper. Just focus on what you feel in the body and go from there. Let go of expectation of what you think should be happening and just allow everything to be organic. Inhale, bend the knees, exhale, float forward. Inhale, lengthen, and exhale, fold. Little deeper now. Chair pose, bend the knees, sit back, arms gaze up. Exhale, samasitihi. Two more. Utkatasana, inhale, gaze up. Exhale, fold, gaze to your knees. Inhale, lengthen, gaze down. Exhale, send it back, high to low. Keep the gaze, the tip of your nose. Right foot forward, back foot flat. Warrior one. Inhale, arms up, look up. Exhale, release. Send it back. Same thing on the other side. Left foot forward. Let's meet in downward facing. Breath and bandhas. If you can completely focus on your breath and your energy locks, you will be present in the moment. The mind will be clear, thoughts will be at bay. Good. Up on the toes, bend the knees. Exhale, float. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, fold. Utkatasana chair, sit back, arms up, gaze up, stand up, samasitihi. One more, Utkatasana, good, Uttanasana fold. Inhale, lengthen, Ardha, exhale, send it back, high to low. Up dog, exhale, down dog, right foot forward, back heel down. Inhale, arms up, look up, exhale, release, send it back. Left foot forward. Good. Let's land in down dog and pause. All right, inhale up on the toes, bend your knees, exhale, float. Inhale, lengthen, and exhale, fold. Chair pose, sit back, arms up, gaze up, stand up, samasthitihi. Let's step the feet hip-width distance, bring your hands to your hips. Inhale, lean back into a back bend here, anchor the tailbone, open up through the chest, the collarbone, the shoulders, and then exhale, fold. Peace fingers come around the big toes. Inhale, lengthen, and then exhale, fold. Elbows splay, head drops. Gaze can be to the tip of the nose, the navel, straight behind you. As long as your gaze is steady, that's what we really want to focus on. Every exhalation, we draw ourselves in just a little deeper. Good. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, hands to hips. Inhale, rise, and exhale, samasthitihi. Big toes touch, hands together. Inhale, step your right foot back, just about 4 feet. Spin your right toes to the back of your mat. Bring your arms to a T. Exhale, reach to the right, and then just drop your right hand down to your shin, wherever the hand lands. left arm to the sky. Look up towards your left hand. Okay, if it bothers your neck to look up, look down, or find a neutral position. Good, now roll the left shoulder down the back, external rotation. Keep the right hand nice and light here. You can use a block here if you want to, placing it on the inside or outside of your leg, but make sure you're not leaning forward here. We want everything in one plane. Good, exhale, look down and inhale, rise. Just flip-flop those feet, turn the right toes in and the left toes to the front of the mat. Stretch and reach, and then drop down. Right arm up, anchor the tailbone, lengthen through the crown of the head. Left hand is light, right shoulder externally rotating, and then drishti. Where is your gaze? Steady and focused. Good, exhale, look down and inhale, rise. Bring your hands to your hips and turn and face the back of your mat. Step your left foot in a little bit so your back heel is flat and square your hips to the back. Left arm reaches up, inhale, look up. Exhale, take a fold. Take your left hand to the inside of your right foot. Pull the right hip back. Okay, lift and lengthen up through your chest. Rotate open through that right shoulder and reach your right arm up. Revolve triangle. For a little more of a challenge, hand can come to the outside. You can also place your hand on a block here. Focus on your breath and your energy locks, your bandhas. Sensation in your body. Exhale, look down, inhale, rise. Good. Hands to hips, turn to the front of the mat. Same thing here. Step your back foot in, square the hips forward. Right arm reaches, inhale, and exhale, fold. Right hand down. Lift, rotate, and then reach. Steady gaze, steady low belly. Exhale, look down, inhale, rise all the way up to a T. Samasthitihi, step back to the top of your mat. Step your right foot back again, arms out, spin your right toes to the back, and lunge into your right knee. Let's see if we can get the thigh parallel. We want a nice deep lunge here. Take the right forearm to your right thigh and sweep your left arm down and then towards or over your head, over your ear. Good. I was gonna say towards the ocean. Roll the left shoulder back. You can use this elbow as resistance to help you with rotation. You can take that hand down deeper, inside or outside of the foot. You decide what works best. Keep opening up. Try not to let those hips sink down. Keep that right leg nice and strong here. Look up towards your left hand or find a neutral position for your neck and keep your eyes steady. Good, exhale, look down, inhale, rise. Ooh, nice and strong here. Flip the feet, left toes forward. Lunging, start with your forearm down. Sweep the arm down and then up and open. It really helps to externally rotate that shoulder. And if you want to go deeper, start to take the hand down. Gaze up towards the fingers or find a position for your neck that works for you. Of course, you can use a block on the inside or outside of your foot if you like. Good, exhale, look down. Inhale, rise up to your T. Samasthitihi, let's step back to the top of your mat. All right, step the right foot back again, 5 feet, nice and wide. Toes straight forward, arms out. Interlace your fingers behind your back. Now roll the shoulders back, take a little back bend, open up, look up, and then exhale, fold. Lift your arms up and away from the back. Let the head hang heavy as you look, either behind you or to the tip of your nose, maybe even to your belly. Thank you. Good. Inhale, rise all the way up. Bring your arms to a T. Let's take one more forward fold. Take your peace fingers around those big toes. Lift halfway up to prepare, and then fold in deeper. Drop the head and pull yourself in a little bit deeper. Play with the movement of your tailbone. Good. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, hands to hips. Let's inhale, rise, arms to a T, and exhale, back to the top of the mat, Samasthitihi. All right, step the right foot back, 2 to 3 feet, arms to a T. We're gonna bring the hands behind the back into a reverse prayer position. So your fingers can turn up, you can point them down or just catch your elbows. Turn to the back of the mat and square out through your hips so your both heels are flat, okay? Lean back and lift your chest. Inhale, look up, and exhale, fold. Bring your belly and your chest, your nose, your forehead towards your shin. Parsvottanasana. Just try to find that even foundation through the feet. Embrace the movement, the sensations. And you're practicing with santosha, contentment, not wanting anything more or anything less than what you have right now. Good, inhale, rise. Turn to the front, readjust the arms. Lean back, look up, and exhale, fold. Take the gaze towards your leg, maybe towards your navel, you decide. If the elbows are dropping, kind of pull them back a little bit. And breathe, sink deeper with every exhalation. Good, inhale, rise. Turn to the right. Arms to a T. Ooh, feel that release through your wrists. Samasthitihi. Come back to the top of the mat. All right, we're going to come into some balance. So let's start by lifting the right knee up. Now you can just hold the right knee up here, or take your peace fingers, grab your right big toe, and extend the leg out in front of you. Left hand to your left hip. Eyes steady. Belly in. Lift the chest. It's okay if this knee's bent a little bit. Just don't lean forward to try and catch the foot. Nice upright posture. Good. Inhale, and then exhale. Open your leg out to the side again. If your knee's bent, you just keep the knee bent, and then feel that nice openness through the right hip. You can take your gaze over your left shoulder to increase the challenge in this balance. Good, inhale, bring it to center, and exhale, release the right foot down, and let's switch sides. Left knee up, catch your knee or big toe, straighten out, right hand to right hip. Good, inhale, and exhale, open to the side. And you can challenge your balance by looking over the right shoulder. Inhale to center and exhale, release all the way down. Hands to heart center. Inhale, float your arms above your head. And exhale, take a forward fold. Inhale, lengthen. Plant your hands, take it back, high to low. Up dog, inhale. Down dog, exhale. All right, we're gonna jump to a seated position. So jump forward, sit down, and extend both legs out in front of you. Dandasana, staff pose. Take your wrists directly under the shoulders, your fingers point forward. Sit up tall, lift your chest, inhale, and then exhale, tuck the chin down. Focus on all three bandhas. Maha bandha engaging. Good. Inhale, release. Exhale, fold. Grab your big toes with your peace fingers. Inhale, lift to prepare, and then exhale, fold. Every breath gets us deeper. Good, go ahead, rise. Let's take a vinyasa. Cross your legs, plant your hands, and take it back. High to low. Up dog to down dog. Let's take it back forward to a seated position. Extend both legs out, and then bend your right knee, placing the sole of your right foot to the inside of your left thigh. Sit up tall, inhale, exhale, fold. It's Janu, Shirshasana A. Lift up halfway to prepare, and then fold deeper. Inhale, rise, switch legs, left foot in, right leg extends, sit up tall, breathe in, exhale, fold, lift up, and then fold deeper. Good, rise up, take a vinyasa, step or hop back, high to low push-up, up dog, downward dog, back to seated, extend both legs out, this time bend your right knee, keep your right foot to the inside of the left thigh, take your right hand behind you, reach your left arm up, inhale, and then exhale, twist, we're going to hook, gaze over your shoulder, sit up tall, embrace this twist that cleanses internally. Energizes the spine and helps keep it healthy and flexible. Good, exhale, look forward. Go ahead, release, switch sides. Left knee bends, left hand behind you. Right arm up, inhale, and exhale, twist. Good, inhale, look forward. Let's release, vinyasa, send it back. Jump forward again. This time we come to boat, balancing on your seat, okay? So we're gonna lean back slightly, roll the shoulders back, keep your low belly in, lift your legs, lift your arms. You can keep your hands behind your legs, release, knees bent, or straighten your legs. Tuck the tailbone. Keep the gaze up, bond is engaged, strengthening the core. All right, cross your legs, bring them up nice and close. Place your hands by your sides and just push up and lift your hips and maybe pick up your feet, drop down, back to Navasana. Cross the legs, hands to your sides, bump up, maybe, oh, lift those feet, lower down, vinyasa, take it back. Good, jump back forward, have a seat, and roll onto your back. You're gonna bend your knees here, arms to your sides. Good, tuck the tailbone under, start to peel your spine up, walk your shoulders in, interlace your fingers, if you can, into our bridge pose. Good. Really press through all four corners of your feet. Press down through your arms and your hands. Stay steady and focused on your breath. Good. You can stay here if you want to go deeper. Drop your hips down. Place your hands under your shoulders, fingers pointing towards your feet. And again, tuck the tailbone. As you lift up, press up through your hands and your feet into upward bow. And slowly release. Hands or knees to chest. Rock all the way up and extend your legs out. Sit up nice and tall and exhale, fold. This time, wrap your palms over the ball mounts of your feet. Pull in, lift halfway, and then pull in deeper. Good, rise up. All right, come onto your back, bring your knees to your chest, and extend your legs to the sky. Stay here or come into shoulder stand, lift your hips, place your hands on the low back, walk them up the back, and lengthen your feet towards the sky. Keep the legs engaged, the feet active. You can come into Padmapada, lotus foot, where you really press through the ball mounts of the feet, and then you spread the toes nice and wide. Good, take your feet behind you, plow pose. And then slowly roll onto your back, extending both feet to the front of your mat, arms to your sides, fish pose, Matsyasana. Lift up onto the elbows, open the chest, and let the head fall back. Bring your knees to chest and rock up to seated. All right. So coming into lotus, half lotus, or just a regular cross-legged position. Coming into lotus, extend your legs out and bring the right foot to the left hip crease, left foot into that right hip crease. If that's too much, just do a half lotus. Right leg in and then left foot comes under, or a regular seated position will work just fine. Sit up tall, turn your palms up and engage finger and thumb. Lengthen up through your spine, take a deep breath in, and then exhale, drop your chin to your chest. Now take very, very slow breaths in and out. So maybe find a count. Let's try a count of eight. Let's inhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, exhale, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now try it to the count of 8 in your head. Final breath in and out. Good. Slowly release. Come on to your back. Extend both feet to the front of the mat. And arms rest by your side. Time for rest for Shavasana. So we will be here for about a minute in this video. So I encourage you to stay as long as you can. Go ahead, pause the video. Give yourself at least 5 minutes if you have it in your day today to take rest. Thanks so much for joining me. Namaste.